Hey YouTube, I'm Jimmy. In this video, I'm going to walk through my analysis of the Markel Corporation, ticker symbol MKL. You may have heard this company called the Mini Berkshire Hathaway. But is it worth buying today? Is Markel worth adding to one of our portfolios, maybe the value portfolio, the growth portfolio? Let's take a closer look. So the Markel Corporation is set up a lot like Berkshire Hathaway is. They describe themselves as a holding company for insurance, reinsurance, and investment operations all around the world. So, how about we start with the insurance aspect of their business, then from there we'll take a look at their investments, and then we'll jump over to see if we can determine what MKL stock should be worth. Now, you may remember when I did my analysis of the Travelers companies that I spoke about an insurance-specific ratio called the combined ratio. This ratio looks at the profitability of the insurance business. It combines two different ratios, the expense ratio and the loss ratio. This is Markel's expense ratio going over the past few years. And as we can see, it's been mostly trending lower, although it did jump up a bit in 2018. So the expense ratio tells us how much Markel spends on managing the insurance business. So for every $100 that they bring in from premiums from their customers, well, in 2018, as an example, they spent $38 managing the business. In 2016, it was $39. And back in 2012, well, it was almost $43. So from a business perspective, we want this number to be as low as possible. So the fact that it appears to be trending lower is a good thing for the insurance business. Okay, the other piece of the combined ratio is called the loss ratio. And this looks at how much premiums were brought in and how much they paid out in claims. So it looks like in 2018, Markel paid about $60 in claims for every $100 in premiums that they brought in. Combine these two ratios and we end up with the combined ratio. Now, the key to the combined ratio is where it sits relative to 100. So if the combined ratio was exactly 100, well, that would mean that the insurance business would have broken even because they would have paid out 100% of what they brought in. So in 2017, Markel lost about 5% because their combined ratio was 105. So they paid out 105% of what they brought in. Last year was 98, which means they made about 2% profit. They only paid out 98% of what they brought in. But there are lots of insurance companies out there. So why do they call this one Mini Berkshire? Well, it's their investments. It's the way that Markel attacks the investment side of the insurance business. This is a quick look at some of the companies that Markel has for their ownership with the money that they have under float. They have companies like Amazon, Home Depot, Disney, Nike, and the list goes on and on. Now, if we were to compare this to a company like Travelers Insurance, well, Travelers invest in mostly municipal bonds or bond-like investments, something safe and stable. That's what makes this a Mini Berkshire, because they're going after high-quality companies, long-term holdings. Now, this comes with some advantages and some disadvantages. One advantage leads us to valuing MKL stock. So a popular way to value insurance companies is to use a price-to-book multiple. This is a chart of Markel's book value per share going back almost 10 years. And as we can see, it's been growing nicely every year except for last year. And we'll come back to that in a minute. Now, assuming that the price to book value stayed the same, well, we could assume that the price of the stock would move about in line with the book value per share. And when we add price to this chart, well, we can see that it did in fact move with the book value per share. So what happened in 2018? Because clearly investors didn't like it, or at least some of them didn't like it. So I was looking at their 10K, which just came out a few days ago, and management made it very clear that the reason that book value per share pulled back was because of unrealized losses. So my question was, is this a big deal? And ultimately, what does it mean? Well, for short, from a business perspective, I don't think that this is a big deal at all. In fact, if you read Buffett's most recent annual letter to shareholders, well, you may have noticed that he kicked off that letter talking about a recent change to U.S. accounting rules. And basically, what the change was that now unrealized losses or gains are going to be included in net income for companies that invest in other companies. And as we know, net income that isn't paid out to shareholders, well, it gets moved over to the balance sheet through retained earnings into the book value section. So we could see that what happened was investors see that book value pulls back for the first time in a decade, the stock begins to fall, and some of them start jumping out. But I think that this could be where the opportunity lies. To illustrate my point, book value per share fell from 2017 to 2018 by about 4.4%. So how did the market react? Well, MKL's stock from the peak at 2017 was a bit over $1,100 per share. Now it's below $1,000. So the market reacted by selling the stock off by more than 13%. So basically, book value declines by less than 5% and the stock falls by more than 13%. And this is especially important when we consider that the decline was primarily due to Markel being forced to mark the stocks that they own, right now and they intend to own for a long time. Well, they had to value those based on the price at the close of business at the end of 2018. And just so we're all on the same page, this is what happened to the stock market for 2018. So I thought it was a bit strange that Markel now has to value all of their holdings at this point as compared to, let's pretend the year had ended right there. Well, had it ended up high, they would have shown gains for the year. And because it arbitrarily ended when it did, well, this is where the stock, this is how they end up with losses for the year. There was nothing fundamentally different about their business from my perspective. And I know what you're saying. Won't all this stuff shake itself out over the long run? And you're right. Good point. But personally, I think that it's bad for an insurance company to end up having to show the volatility of what would appear to be a much less stable company. The good news is that from our perspective, it makes sense for us to simply wait for the market to react to these extreme volatility swings, and then we could jump in and buy the stock, assuming that we want to hold it for a long period of time. Well, the extreme volatility probably won't matter that much to us. In fact, it might present opportunities for us to jump in and out. And as you pointed out, over the long run, it will all shake itself out. Okay, so let's try to value the mini Berkshire Hathaway. Do we think it's worth buying today, or do we need to fall even further before we think it's something worth adding to our portfolio? So let's use price to book value, since that's widely accepted as a great way to value insurance companies. So right now, MKL's price to book value is about 1.5 times last year's book value, or the most recent book value. We get that by simply taking the $990 per share right now and dividing that by the $653 for last year's book value. To try to determine what it should be trading at, well, I pulled down the price to book value over the past few years, and we could see that since the start of 2016, well, the average over that time period was about 1.6x. And if we were to price MKL stock based on that 1.6x, well, what we end up with is a fair value of about $1,050. This is a chart of MKL's stock, and it looks like if it were trading at 1.6x, MKL should be trading right about there. So sure, MKL looks a bit undervalued, and perhaps it could be a good buy, but personally, I'd prefer for MKL's stock to fall even further before we go ahead and add it to any portfolio. Because personally, I like great value opportunities. I think that MKL is doing some very interesting things, and it could be a great addition to the growth portfolio. Now, some of the things that I came across is that MKL recently made an acquisition of an investment company that specializes in managing reinsurance risk. I thought that was a great addition for them, very smart for them to do. Anything to improve the overall business should help them continue to grow. I also came across a class action lawsuit against MKL, and there were some serious allegations in that. And I think this is something we need to watch, although I do know that large companies like this get sued often, so I'm not sure how seriously to take it at this point, but I do think it's worth keeping in the back of our minds. So the good news is that MKL looks like a very solid business. I expect them to continue to push their business forward, and perhaps they really end up living up to the reputation of being the baby Berkshire Hathaway. And maybe they even end up growing their current business, which has a market cap of about $14 billion. And if they get anywhere near the Berkshire Hathaway size of $500 billion, well, that would make for one hell of an investment. But what do you think? Is Markel a good buy today? I can see it as a growth company in a growth portfolio. Doesn't seem quite the value opportunity at this point. It doesn't pay a dividend, so it wouldn't belong there. But I could still make a case for it being a good buy over the long haul. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you haven't done so already, hit the subscribe button. Thank you for sticking with me all the way to the end of the video, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.